Assalamualaikum and hi guys. Dah lama saya tak buat vlog macam ni kan. Quite sometimes jugalah. No excuse. Cuma recently saya the priority is different has shifted a little bit. My focus now is more on my professional life. Banyak kerja sikit nak kena settle kan. So that's why saya kurang ada kesempatan untuk shoot and do the editing lah. Another thing, have you watched my recent podcast? My first podcast ever published tau. Woohoo! It's a good thing to start with. That is one of my plan for 2021 to have a collaboration with my friends, with my fellow YouTubers and siapa-siapa lah yang sudi nak berkolaborasi. So, if you haven't watched my podcast, I put a link here, nanti spend some time, watch the podcast. This is one thing yang saya nak share. Baru-baru ni, tak adalah baru ni, macam this week, few days ago, saya ada order pizza, Domino's Pizza, which is my favourite. Sebab dia punya crust ni memang best. And furthermore, you can have, kalau tak silap, dia ada 3 jenis crust yang you boleh pilih. Hand toss, yang the normal crust. Thin crust, the very thin crust tu, memang crunchy. And then the final one is the New York crust kot, kalau tak silap. That one yang besar, kalau tak silap yang besar kot. Anyway, bukan pasal crust, I'm not gonna review the food. It's about my experience dengan Domino's Pizza ni. So, bila saya order pizza tu, my last order was early February. And then, bila you login to the website, the portal itu, and you have the option to reorder based on your last order hari tu. So, you tak payah nak fikir-fikir nak apa, you just click reorder, then make a payment, done. So, I did just that lah. So, I malas nak fikir-fikir nak pilih apa sebab I nak makan benda yang sama. My wife pun nak makan benda yang sama. So, I just reorder based on my last order, and then I waited for the delivery. Lepas tu bila dah dapat, sekali dia tengok, kenapa dia bagi satu aloha dengan satu lagi barbecue chicken. Sedangkan based on my last order, it was a tuna temptation dengan barbecue chicken. So I called dia punya ni, customer service. I called dia punya customer service and then I reported that the pizza yang dia salah hantar tu lah. And then dia cakap, it's okay cik, nanti saya akan check dengan the outlet and then I call you back in 5 minutes. So okay lah. And then, within 5 minutes rasanya kot. Then dia call back, dia cakap, cik, macam ni, pizza yang ada tu, yang ada alha tu, cik boleh makan. Yang dia salah hantar tu, cik boleh makan. But at the same time, dia akan hantar the tuna temptation tu. I cakap, that's good. It's a good thing, it's a good experience for me lah. It's because masa tu I tak buka lagi pizza tu pun. My understanding nanti I nak kena pulangkan lah pizza tu kan sebab I tak order. Tapi they are kind enough to let me have that pizza and then they are also kind enough to send another pizza based on my last order tu. Because I think that is on their system punya mistake lah. Thank you Domino's for your superb customer service. I don't have any problem so far with Domino's Pizza. Good job Domino's, good job. This is another new thing to me. Pernah dengar Clubhouse kan? Duk kecoh-kecoh pasal Clubhouse lah, Clubhouse ni lah. So, unfortunately Clubhouse ni only available on iPhone. Dia tak ada dekat Android phone ni, tak ada. So, I was thinking okay, menulai macam tak kisah sangat lah kan. Macam takpelah, I'm using Android. So memang I tak dapat lah join Clubhouse. I just need to wait for the apps to be released on Android platform tu je lah. But in the meantime, curiosity, orang cakap curiosity kills the cat kan. Luckily I'm not the cat, I'm a human. So I decided to get on board using my daughter's iPhone. So I install Clubhouse on iPhone. And then I blast dekat WhatsApp, dekat Twitter. To get some invite lah, because Clubhouse sekarang ni dia macam Gmail awal-awal dulu where you need to get the invitation to create an account apa semua kan lah. So that's Clubhouse sekarang lah. So dia macam exclusive sikit. So Alhamdulillah ada my friend yang sudi untuk invite saya into Clubhouse. I'm on board now. I'm still learning what is Clubhouse is all about. I joined a few Clubhouse session dekat dalam tu. I don't know what do they call it lah. I call it session lah. A room, Clubhouse room eh. Dia macam, it's like a podcast because it's an audio only. It's like a live podcast lah, real time where you can communicate, you can have a two-way conversation dengan the speakers. So dia ada konsep, dia akan ada someone yang moderate the room, and then this moderator nanti akan invite the speaker, siapa akan appoint the speaker apa semua, and the audience or the listeners tu nanti I tak pernah try lagi, you can raise your hand and then the moderator can allow you to speak kot. I heard they said that you can record the session, but I think just for the moderator lah. I don't know whether, because as a listener I cannot record the session. Tu saja sekarang saya tengah explore Clubhouse. Quite interesting. Cuma I'm still trying to learn about it. To learn more about Clubhouse ni lah. And I hope they can expand it to other platform as well. And tu sajalah my update. Till then, see you when I see you. Jangan lupa tau tengok I punya podcast tu.